हेलो नमस्कार, खुश रहो बच्चों। आई एम जेबीएन डॉक्टर शाहनवाज आलम, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट कंसेप्ट ऑफ मनी एंड बैंकिंग एंड पब्लिक फाइनेंस। टुडे टॉपिक इज मेथड ऑफ डेट रिडेम्पशन। रिडेम्पशन ऑफ डेट रेफर्स टू द रीपेमेंट ऑफ द पब्लिक लोन, ऑल्दो पब्लिक डेट should be paid. Debt redemption is desirable too in order to save the government from bankruptcy and to raise the confidence of lender. The government has to redeem its debt from time to time. The following method used for redemptions of public debt. First, refunding. The government often issues new bonds for raising new loan in order to pay off the matured loan. Thus, the government takes a fresh loan in order to repay an old debt. When the government issues the method of refunding these, there is no liquidation of the money burden of the public debt. Instead, the debt servicing repayment of interest along with the principal burden get the accumulated on account of the postponement of the debt repayment to some future date. Use budgetary surplus. Sometimes a government is able to generate a surplus in the budget. In such a situation, the government is left with no options. It can either reduce the taxes or repay some of its old debt. In general, the government make use of the budgetary surplus to buy back from the markets or people its own bonds or securities. As a result, there is an automatic liquidation of the debt liabilities of the government. In some country, the government follow the directives of paying off debt of loans in terminal. By the using the method, the government pay off the debt in general equal annual installment. This is method often the fund favor with the planners and policy maker in developing countries seeking funds. Sometimes the government of country establish the separate fund known as seeking fund for the purpose of repaying its debt. Under this system, the government goes crediting the fixed amount of money to this fund every year by the time the debt matures. Sufficient money get accumulated in the fund so as to enable the government to repay the debt along with interest. In general, there are in fact two alternative way of crediting some to the fund. The usual procedure to deposit the certain percentage of its annual income to the funds. Debt conversion. Sometimes a high interest debt is converted into low interest ones. The question here is when is this possible? Let us suppose the government contracts the debt when the existing rate of interest is quite high, but after some time, the market rate of interest may fall. The gives the government an opportunity to convert high interest debt into low interest debt. Statutory reduction in the rate of interest. Sometimes the government passes the ordinance to reduce the rate of interest payable on debt. This happens when the government suffers from the financial crisis and when there is huge deficit in its budget. There are so many instances of the compulsory reductions in the rate of interest. Additional taxation. Sometimes the government imposes the additional tax on the people to pay interest public debt by the laying new taxes, both direct and indirect. The government can collect the necessary revenue so as to be able to pay off its old debt. However, this method is often criticized on the ground that it creates inequality in the distribution of the income by redistribution income from taxpayer to the bondholder. This is why it is said that if income tax revenue is used to pay interest on public debt, there is net burden of community. Capital levy. In times of war, emergency, most of government follow the unusual practice of repaying its debt by the imposing the capital levy on its citizens. Kings also agreed to this method when discuss the different method of paying for a war. A capital levy is just like a wealth tax using trade surplus. The method discussed above the used to repay interest internal debt. However, when the government borrowed from the other country, it has to service the debt in foreign exchange. The burden of country external debt is measured by debt service ratio. When are the country repayment obligation of the obligation of principal and interest for a particular year on its external debt as percentage of its export of goods and services in the year. And external debt is unusually paid of foreign currency or goods. If a country is unable to repay the debt, it has to export goods abroad. For this, it is to generate an export surplus. Has to raise export and reduce import and make the next export the balance of trade is favorable. If a country is able to generate export surplus or balance of trade surplus, there will be net inflow of foreign exchange into country. This will enable the debtor country to repay the foreign trade. In next lecture, we will discuss about growth of Indian public debt. Thank you.